Tamasa River, we have also come across that river in the very beginning. In the very beginning, that Tamasa River is the river where, say, Valmiki, say, he saw that hunter and then he saw that hunter killing the bird and whatnot. So, that is the Tamasa River. So, meanwhile, they reached that Tamasa River. So, here, of course, if we see this particular chapter, this particular sarga, these Brahmins, they are saying, you have to follow dharma. If you do not follow dharma, who else will follow dharma? So, they are no doubt very learned people. But then, Rama, their analysis of dharma is not so great, not so perfect. So, that is the reason why Rama is not arguing with them. Rama is not replying to them. Rama is simply keeping quiet. He gave all respect to them by getting down from the chariot along with Sita and Lakshmana. He moved along with them, but he did not discuss with them. He did not argue with them. Now, we will see how he is going to handle them, because he is totally, he is just keeping quiet. In the next sarga, we will see that he is just avoiding them all and then say getting into the jungle without their knowledge. So, that is what we will see in the next sarga. So, the next sarga is sarga number 46. So, here say all the citizens they were following Rama, we saw in the earlier sarga, when all the people they just came, and then by that time it was evening, and then they all wanted to camp there on the banks of Tamasa River. And Rama then tells Lakshmana, oh Lakshmana, this is our first night in the jungle. And he is also observing, it was nightfall, and all the birds had come back to the trees, and there was silence everywhere, and it looked as though it looked as though the whole forest is very, very gloomy. And he is also recalling about what could be the situation in Ayodhya. He says, even in Ayodhya, people probably would be very, very they would be crying and wailing, they would be sorrowful. And he says, the people in general, they have respect for our entire family. It is not as though they respect me alone or you alone. They respect Bharata Shatrughna, Shatrughna Bharatau Tatha. We see Anuraktahi Manuja Rajanam Bahuvirgunaihi. They respect Rajanam, that is, they respect the king, that is Dasharatha. And similarly, Tvamcha Mamcha, they respect you, they respect me, and also they respect Bharata and Shatrughna. So, why he is saying is, Bharata is capable of taking care of everything, and then we have to get rid of these people, let all these people go back. So, that is what we are going to see. So, he says, Pitaramcha Anushochami Mataramcha Yashasvinim. So, he says, I am only worried about my father and mother, you see, because of that excessive sorrow and lamenting. They may apinandhav bhavetam now, crying and crying, they may even become blind. So, that is what he says. But immediately he checks and says, but Bharata will surely console them suitably. Bharata is going to, Bharata khalu dharmatma pitaram matarancheme dharmartha kama sahitaihi vakyaihi ashwasa ishyati. Bharata is such a gentleman, and say he will be able to console them with words which are associated with dharma, artha and kama. Dharma, artha, kama, these are the three purusharthas with which all of us are connected. Moksha, of course, is individual. Moksha is an individual pursuit, whereas in all other matters, we are all connected with dharma, artha and kama. So, that is how he says, Bharata will be able to, he is a wise man, he will be able to console them, and he will be able to be kind to them also. And Bharata's kindness, he recalls, Bharatasya anrusham sattvam. Anrusham sattvam is his kindness, his gentle behavior, you see. So, I am not worried about our parents, because Bharata will take care of them. And he tells Lakshmana, it is good that you have followed me. Tvaya karyam naravyagra maam anuvrajata kritam. You see, you have done a great thing following me, because I would have found it difficult to be always taking care of Sita. I need somebody, I need some help to take care of Sita. So, you have done a good thing that you have followed. And then they say, they decide, okay, we will stay here tonight, we will camp here. And Rama says, of course, today I will not take any food, I will only take some water. And so, like that, he says to, he tells them. And meanwhile, he also tells Sumantra, now you untie the horses. You see, horses are still yoked to the chariot. So, he says, untie the chariot, untie the horses, let the horses take rest, and then let us also take rest. Then Sumantra, you see, upasyatu shivam sandhyam drushtva ratrim upagatam. You see, Sumantra is doing sandhya, sandhyopasana. Who is this Sumantra? Sumantra is not a Brahmana, Sumantra is not a Kshatriya, then what is he? He is a Suta, but he is still also, he is doing Sandhyopasana. And what does it indicate? Why we are going slow in reading Ramayana is that just to see various points so that we can see the life in those days, in those times, you see. Suta is, he is also a person who is doing Sandhyopasana. Sita also will see doing Sandhyopasana, which we will also see in Sundarakanda. So, this was something which was a common practice for all, and somehow it is now over a period of time, it is given up because probably nowadays only some Brahmanas and some Vaishyas, they do the Sandhyopasana, and many other people have just left it, but it was there for everybody. I only wish that our Swamiji's there, how great it would be if all the Swamis revive this practice, I sometimes feel. So, he does Sandhyopasana. And then he prepares bed for Rama and Lakshmana. He prepares a bed with all this bed of leaves, viksha vrukshadala irvurutam, vrukshadala, vrukshadala means all these leaves from all these forest branches, he prepares a bed. So, we will continue in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.